In this lecture, we are going to discuss some example of DFA. Now, how can we define the language accepted by DFA? It can be defined as LM equal to W belongs to summation star such that delta star Q0W belongs to F. It means L is our language, M is DFA, so it becomes language accepted by DFA, M. W is our string. And naturally, W, it's a combination of summation star. Summation star means any combination of alphabets including null. So, W belongs to summation star. Such that, delta is our transition function. Q0 is our start state. So, at the start state, we are getting this string as input. One by one, we consume the alphabet symbols, and if finally we are at final state, then only we can say the given string is accepted by our DFA. Otherwise, it is not accepted. For example, we are constructing a DFA here to see this example. Q1 is B. Here Q2 our final state, so we are putting double circle here. This is self loop. Now B, this is our state Q3. GP. And this A. So, we take an example DFA and we see the strings which is going to be accepted by this one. So, Q0 is our start state and Q2 is our final state. Now, we can notice one thing. From start state to final state, if you want to move from start state to final state, first we consume a symbol A, then B. After that, any number of symbols from A and B can be consumed. It is not compulsory. It is up to our choice. But starting from the start state, we got a B. Then we come to Q3, and from Q3, we cannot come out because there is no outgoing edges except this self loop. So, Q3, here it is trap state or dead state. Means, once we come to Q3, we cannot go out. So, the chances to reach to final state is vanished. Now, we take a string, for example, AAP. Is it accepted by our DFA? So, from start state Q0, A is filled. From Q0 to A, we move to Q1. Our new state is Q1 and this symbol A is consumed. From Q1, we get B as input. From Q1 to B, we are in Q2. So our new state is Q2 and this symbol is also consumed. So all the input symbols were consumed. We are in state Q2, which is our final state. So this string AB is accepted. Similarly, we can notice one thing. All strings in which AB as prefix will be accepted by this DFA. Because after getting AB, we are at final state Q2 and there is a self loop. So no matter how many symbols are here, AB, 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 infinitely many, it can be accepted. So can we generalize the language accepted by DFA in this case? Yes, we can say this DFA is going to accept all the strings W belongs to summation star such that W start with prefix AB. Prefix AB. So AB, AB, it is also accepted. AB, B, B, AB, it is also accepted. But BAB, it is not accepted, because this string, in this case, AB is not our prefix. So this is language accepted by DFA. We can generalize it. Now we take a few other examples. So in this case, what is the language accepted by our DFA? So in this case, our queue is, let us state they are Q0 and Q1. Alphabet symbols, they are just A. Delta is our transition function, and start state is Q0 and final state is Q1. So we can see, starting from start state, if we got A as input, we move to Q1. Q1 is our final state, so A is mandatory to reach the final state. After that, it is optional. We can take as many as A as it is needed, or we cannot take any. So just A is accepted. AA is also accepted. AAA is also accepted. So can it be written in the form of any formal language? Yes. We can write it as a to the power n, such that n greater than or equal to 1. This is the language accepted by this DFA. We cannot put 0 here, because if we put 0 here, it is also going to accept null. In this case, next example, what this DFA is going to accept? It will accept just null, null only, because the final state and start state, they are same. What about this case? In this case, it can accept null, A, any combination of A. So in this case, we can write the language accepted by DFA is a to the power n, such that n greater than or equal to 0. Notice the difference between this and this. In this case, n is greater than or equal to 1. In this case, n is greater than or equal to 0. So it is not mandatory to take any A. We are already in final state, so it is going to accept null also. In this case, null is not accepted. What about this case? Here, at the start state, we can take any number of A's, for example, A. Then, if we take a B, we move to Q1. Finally, from Q1, if we get any symbols, we move to Q2, which is our trap state. We cannot come back. So, in this case, the language accepted by DFA can be written as A to the power N and B, such that n is greater than or equal to 0 or 1. Self loop, it is always 0, because we can take it or we can ignore it. So in this case, our language becomes a to the power n b, such that n greater than or equal to 0. Okay.